Hi, I'm Guru Mark Halleck, and welcome to Panintucan Sea Lot Level 5. Hope you enjoy it and have fun. First thing we're going into is what we call the Hammer and Anvil series. Now, you'll understand what I mean by hammer and anvil as you see the finishing motion, but all the techniques are going to end basically with your hammer and anvil. So he's going to jab cross. I'm going to catch. I'm going to outside deflect. I'm going to uppercut. I'm going to pull back, and I'm going to hit his head. So as I pull back, this gives me that shot. I lift his arm, I pull his head through, and I take him straight down. He lands sitting up on my knee. I wrap this, and I start pounding him in the face. Hence the name Hammer and Anvil. My leg is the anvil, my hand is the hammer, his face is my material. Now, he doesn't want to get hit in the face, so when the opponent puts the hand up to block, I grab it, I pull it out of the way, trade it to this hand, and now I finish hammering. So watch again. Catch, parry, uppercut, pull, slap, lift, pull him straight back. Now, my hand was behind his head the entire time. I don't want his head bouncing off my knee right now. On the street, I'm all for it, but right now I'm supporting his head so he doesn't bounce off my leg. I wrap this arm. I hammer him in the face. Any smart person is going to put their hand up to block, grab it, pull it out of the way, and then just finish. Okay, number two, catch, uppercut. Now I grab his head and I tuck the arm behind me. He is basically stuck here. I'm gonna knee him in the face. I'm gonna stuff his head through. He's gonna land sitting up, hammer. He puts his hand up, grab it, move it out of the way, and finish. So one, two, up, tuck. He's stuck here. He can feel his arm is wrenched. I can knee here all day, but his hand ends up going in the way of his face. So I stuff the head, he lands on my leg, I start hammering, pull it out of the way, finish him off. Okay, next one. I'm gonna catch. I'm gonna inside guillotine. I'm gonna hack. I'm gonna step forward and drop my weight down. I'm gonna underhook his arm, stuff his head through. He lands sitting up, hammer, pull it out of the way, hammer and anvil. Elbow, hack. I can knee, step. I wanna take my body with him. Give a little scoop, pull his head through, blocks, finish. Okay. Next one. This is where if number three fails. So if I go like this and I hack and I go down and he's not going, this hand is going to come around on top. This hand grabs his chin. I push down, lift up, take him down, start hammering. If his hands come up, I just grab him and pull. This is a really nice neck break as he's going down, so be careful. So I go one, two, elbow, hack, step. He's not going. So when he resists, I push, I lift, and I pull straight back and take him down. Hammer. Whatever hand comes up, pull him out of the way and finish hitting. So I go one, two, elbow, hack, step. Doesn't work. Grab the chin, push the arm down, turn, lift. I can wrap this way. I can hammer this way even and hit like this. Move it out of the way, move it out of the way, hit. Do one more time, that was sloppy. Okay. Hit, whatever hand comes up, pull it, hit, pull it, hit. Now we're going to go into our leg pull down or our leg scissor series. I'm going to show you it off a counter like a sucker punch where he's hit me and I've gone down. Then I'm going to show it to you more in an offensive application. So the first one, here we are. Maybe he sucker punches me. Okay, as he does it again, as I'm going down, I fall down on my right leg. It's on the outside of his foot. I just want to pull his leg, pull him down. I want to roll up and kneel on his shin. Okay? I want to put pressure down like this. This really hurts. Okay? I have his foot up off the floor, and I'm kneeling down on the pressure point right in the middle of his shin. Okay? This is where the nerve is. So watch again. We're talking. Maybe we're arguing. Boom! I go down. I take him with me as I go. I roll up. Kneel here. This is a submission. If I want to abandon this, I can kind of roll this way and kick like this and kick back like that. So again, here we are. Boom. As I fall, I take the leg, roll up, finish. Now, if I want to do that more combative where he jab crosses, I can just parry, come in, sit, and take him down and go up this way. A lot of people don't expect you to drop to the ground. That's what makes this kind of sneaky. So, one, parry. I step, I drop, and I pull at the same time, and I just roll up on his shin. Make sure you get off pretty fast. Okay, next one. Now I'm going to do more a takedown with my legs instead of my hands. So he punches. Again, we're arguing. Boom. As I'm falling, I put this foot out. This foot inserts inside, and I kick it out this way. That would kick to the groin like that. So again, I don't want any trouble, please. He hits me. I fall down. I take this. Kick to the groin. Just because you get hit doesn't mean the fight's over. Okay, you still have to fight. We've all seen these in Hawk's previous videos. You need to keep going. Maybe I'm with my wife and kids. I can't just lay there and play dead. I need to keep going, okay? So one more time, hit, I fall, my leg ends up inside, spring it down, kick to the groin. Next one, we call this a fireman's pull. Be careful on this one because you can really hurt your opponent's leg bad. So, he sucker punches. I'm gonna go with the force and I'm gonna step. As I step, this foot's gonna hook and I'm just gonna sit down on his leg. As he falls back, I pull and I break the knee. So, here we are, he hits, boom, I hook, sit, take him down, pull up and break. Real slow from this side, so I want you to see, I'm sitting on top of his knee and I'm sliding down. So here, my foot hooks, I sit down high on his knee and then start sliding down, which straightens his leg out and takes him down, then I pull for the break. More time, hit, hook, sit, break. Kick to the groin. Okay, last one. This time he's gonna step forward with the right as he sucker punches. So again, we're arguing. I don't want any trouble. He hits. As I turn, I fall, I kick around, and this time I scissor from the outside like this. I like to roll up and trap this, or I'll just let go and go right to the head. Like this is for someone who's stepping as they punch. One, I hit the ground, I turn, scissor high and low. As he rolls, I just continue my roll up his body and hit. Let's go from this side. So boom, here I go. I fall, he comes down, I roll up, finish. Okay, now we're gonna go into our hammerlock series. Now we're gonna start with the drill to get you familiar with the hammerlock, and we're gonna teach you the counter. This would be really good for a law enforcement officer or someone who does security who carries a weapon. Okay, so now what I'm doing is he's just gonna stand, arms at his side. Okay, I am gonna check the weapon. Maybe he's a cop and here's the gun. I'm checking the gun. I'm elbowing the front of the shoulder. I'm coming up and coming over. For practice, we put our hand on the shoulder. The street, I put my hand on his elbow. This is much tighter. This is more forgiving. Then we step back. So I check, elbow, hammerlock. Come back. Check, elbow, hammerlock. One, two, in and over. One, two, in and over. One, two, in and over. Now his counter, when I go one, two, as I'm going in, he grabs his pants. He drops his weight and then he stands up and puts me in a lock. So again, this is why I say this is good for a law enforcement person. I'm the bad guy, I'm trying to get your gun or whatever and you're countering it. So again, I trap, I elbow. As I'm coming in, he grabs his pants, he drops his weight, and he lifts up and captures my elbow. Now we do it on the other side. One, two, as I'm going in, he grabs, he drops, and he lifts. He's got to catch me before my elbow goes through. If my elbow's through, there's nothing here, and I'm going to take him. Okay, so you've got to do this before the elbow goes through. So one, two, as I'm going, he catches it, drops, and lifts up. Then he's going to go again. One, two, in, catch, lift. One, two, in, he drops. One more time, tap, elbow. As I'm inserting, he grabs, pinches, and he lifts. Even if he's down low, he's still going to get me in an arm bar, but then he can straighten it out. So it's okay. It's better to be too soon than too late, because if my arm's through, he really has nothing. But at least here, he's got something, and it's easier for him to adjust and get it that way than it is for him to try to back up and get it. So try to get it somewhere before the elbow, okay, not after.
We're going to go into our CLAT series number two, which is your Sapu and your Kenjit. Now, if you remember, Bisset was back of leg. Sapu is an inside sweep. It can be from the inside or the outside. Sapu Luar is from the inside. Sapu Dalam is from the outside. The way I remember that is Sapu, you are in, Luar, you are in. So you kind of make a little rhyme out of it, and that's how I remember which is which. So Luar, you are in, Dalam is outside. So first thing we're going to do, this is one of my favorite moves. It's really fast, it's easy, and it off-balances him pretty fast. He's going to jab cross. I'm going to catch. I'm just going to deflect. I'm going to grab. I'm going to walk forward and bump the body. He's already off-balanced. I sweep that out, and I finish with a kick. So you can get into this really fast. If he's jab crossing, I can just be in, out, and he's down. So slow. One, two, bump. As soon as he takes that step with the rear leg, he's off balance. That's what you want. You need to offset the body. Once I see this leg go like that, his weight's gone. And that's where you take the sweep. If you don't bump the body, he's not moving, you're not shifting it, and you're not going to get the sweep. If I just come in and go like this, this leg is not going anywhere. And actually, he could take me down. But if I bump him, then the weight's off it, just like that. So it's important to body bump. So again, you can close in on someone. Even if they're punching fast, you could just be in, and he's down, and finish with a stop. One more time. One, two, in, bump, pull, finish. Bump, pull, finish. More. Bump. Finish. Okay. Okay, next we're gonna go off a jab. He's gonna jab. I'm gonna split entry. This would hit to the face. This is gonna scoop. I like to elbow the arm as I'm going through. This is gonna slap the body to turn it. I step. I hook inside, and I pull. Okay, so as I sweep it out, I like to stomp on the calf, and I like to knee to the spine. I can even grab and pull up on the head. Okay, so watch again. Split entry, scoop, elbow, slap, pull, stomp, knee, finish. So this is Sapu Luar. One, scoop, elbow, slap, step, pull, stomp, knee. From this side, inside, scoop, elbow, slap, step, hook, pull, stomp, knee. Next, we're going to go into Kenjit Seiko. Kenjit meets compress. Seiko is elbow. So as he jabs, I'm gonna slap over and punch. I'm gonna punch over with this hand as I step behind. I wanna be, you know, think of, if you're a traditional martial artist, think of like my horse stance. I take my elbow and I drop down and give a little twist. As he falls, we turn and that would hit to the face like that. So I punch over, punch. I need his face turned. His shoulder's in my armpit, holding onto the arm. Bend, I compress down and twist. I turn, finish. We're going to go into is called Kenjutsu. It's another form of Kenjutsu, except I'm not using the elbow. So as he comes in, I'm going to punch over. I trade and this goes to his face. As I'm pulling his head back, I stomp on the back of the leg and take his head down to the floor. And then I would finish. I would like to slam his head into my knee as he's going down. Be very careful when you're doing this. So I go one, grab, step. See how he would go right down into my leg like that? And then I could just finish. For training, I'm taking him to the floor because I'm really not supporting the back of his head and I just want to be careful with my partner. You hurt too many partners, no one's going to want to train with you. So one, grab, step, press, finish. Okay, next one. If that one fails, if your Kenjutsu fails, if I go like this and I'm in and maybe I slide off, I slap, slap, pull, and I'm back to my Sapu Luar. So I'm going for Kenjutsu. As I go like this, I slide off, slap, slap, pull, stomp. Okay, so now we're going to where my Kenjutsu failed. Then I went to my Sapu and this didn't work. So I want to grab, elbow, turn his shoulder, step here, and pull this way. So now I'm going back to the outside. So if I go one, Two fails. Fails. Slap, elbow, pull, down. So again, I need to manipulate his body in order for this to work. So one, failed. Failed. Elbow. Turn, hook, pull, stomp. Now we're going to work our sectors, and I want you to remember from last tape, this is sector one. Now, I'm going to have him face this way at first. He's going to jab cross. I'm going to catch. I'm going to parry. I'm going to step into sector one. I'm going to drop down. I'm going to weave in between his leg, palm facing out. All I have to do is turn my palm in and give a little bump with my shoulder, and he goes down. Now, this is not wrestling. C-Lot does this too. I have a knee in the butt, and I'd be pulling up. So, watch again so you can see from behind. Deflect, step, weave, palm out, turn, follow, take him down. So catch, parry, insert, follow, finish. One more. Okay, next one. He's gonna jab cross. I'm gonna deflect. This time I'm gonna step, I'm gonna kneel, and this is gonna elbow the hip. As he goes down, you can just grab and go back to this lock, or you can just pass it and finish on the ground. So I'm going one, two, elbow. I can stand back up to right where I was, or I can elbow and just stay here, let it go, and finish. Okay, last one. Come on this side. Now this is going to take you back to your coup-de-coude stepping from the last tape. If I go in sector one and I miss, I switch. That's where that footwork drill came in. This slaps to the back and this sweeps that way. And we just take them down and finish like that. So he jab crosses, catch, deflect, step, I miss, pivot into sector two, slap, sweep, take him down, follow up, and hit. go from this side. Catch, hit, missed. Pivot, slap, sweep, finish. One, two, miss. Pivot, slap, sweep, climb up, finish. One more. One, two, miss, pivot, slap, sweep, finish. And that's it. We've now completed DVD number 5, level 5. You're almost through intermediate into advanced instructor. Train hard, learn the material, come see me and test. Thank you very much.